Happy Halloween week, and welcome to week 11 in Seed 508, the diverse 7 through 12 classroom. This week we are going to begin PPAT Task 4, which is implementing and analyzing instruction to inform student learning. So after you watch this video, the first thing I would like for you to do is to go to our live binder, look at Task 4, which Task 4 has 4 steps. Task 4 is weighted more than Task 2 and Task 3 because, as in the videos you watched earlier this semester, the idea is that you learn from Task 2 and Task 3 to make changes in your instruction to inform student learning. What I have in the live binder first, if you click on this, you will get the entire Task 4 requirements from the Educational Testing Service. This link gives you the entire Google Doc for step 1. However, when I looked at how I set up our Dropbox back in August, when I look at how I set up the Dropbox for PPAT Task 4 in the same manner that I did for your work with Task 1 on knowledge of students and background, and then also using the ETS Library of Examples for Task 2, we're going to just continue this same format with Task 4. So you can see that Task 4 involves having a lesson plan, knowing about your students, the instructional strategies that you plan to use, the lesson activities, and finally, I have a folder for you to submit your self-assessment on all of the work that you do. So this is in the Dropbox. So going back to what I have in the live binder for you, if you click on step 1, which is the planning for it, first off, you'll see this document here is the entire thing, but I've also separated the step 1 into its 3 parts. So you have the option of how you want to go about it. You might be thinking differently than me, but I believe in just doing baby steps. Or baby parts, I guess, because step 1 is, an entire thing here. But nevertheless, which way that you use it, you're going to have to submit it into the Dropbox. Either you'll be resubmitting your entire document 3 times, or you'll be submitting the little pieces 1 per time. So I've got the Google Doc. Then I've got the library of examples for you to look at. I could tell from what you've done by looking through the Task 2 library of examples, you're seeing why one of the examples scored well, because it had all the detail, and then one that didn't score well. So you know that detail is what is important there. Then we've got the instructional strategies, which is the second part of step 1. What instructional strategies do you plan to use? And we've talked about instructional strategies already in your work with the Danielson domains, your earlier work even with Task 2, your work with Harry Wong. So what are you going to do? And then part 3 is going to be your lesson activities. And so I'm going to finish this video, but then I'm going to go back and change this link here, because it should be to a Google Doc for just the last part, not on instructional strategies, that's part 2, but on the learning activities. The main thing to remember about this is you're just writing about your lesson plan. So if you have detail in your lesson plan, which can only be 2 pages max when you're submitting next semester, You're just writing about what you're going to do in this lesson. For task four, you will need to be in a classroom because this is pretty much the coup de grace, the capstone lesson of Seed 508, where you're going to have the opportunity to show what you've learned and practiced in your practicum so far or in your classroom so that I know that you'll be ready to do this next semester. Going back to the instructions for this week, I did leave on a link that Dr. Fair had, which is on goal setting theory, because in your lesson plan, you have to write a focus of your lesson and your lesson outcome. It's the same idea of what's the goal of this lesson? What is it that you want your students to do? Link serves two purposes. One for your own goals, how you're going to approach the PPAT task four, implementing and analyzing instruction to inform student learning. And then also in your lesson, what goals do you have for your students as they work through the lesson? As always, and keep up the great work. For this week, normally we have respond to at least two people's discussion posts and read everyone's, which I do want you to do that still, of course. However, I do want you to provide feedback. And by feedback, I mean using comments and track changes to strengthen your peers' work on their writing for step one, part two, and part three. I will have a link to a video on how to use comments and track changes if you're not familiar with using them. For the upcoming weeks, you can go ahead and put your name with a group. I just wanted to have some format for this week. So the first four groups should be in one discussion group, and the second three groups should be in a discussion group. I will make new discussion groups next Sunday based upon where you put your name. I want to give you choice. If you're happy with who you're working with, great. If you would like to mix it up, I think we learn so much more if we are in heterogeneous groups rather than being in the same group all the time. I know there's people that disagree with me, but learning from different perspectives, different content areas, is quite powerful. Well, I hope that's it. As always, if you have any questions, please contact me or post your question to Ask a Question in D2L. Thanks for listening, and I hope we all have a great Halloween week.